G'day boys. Alright, so I got an Evinrude here. I'm having problems with the trim. So it'll trim down, but it won't trim up. It's not working. Possible causes could be this switch. These are real common, these break. The contacts behind underneath here are not well protected. And not often very, people don't put grease, dielectric grease or anything on them, so they get exposed to the elements. But there's some troubleshooting you want to do first before you split this open. So I can tell this switch here, like, it's not really clicking in like it should on here. So the bottom one clicks in positively, but the top one doesn't. But that doesn't mean that that's stuff yet. I'll show you something else. Okay, so at the back of the boat, we'll try this switch. So I've got trim down, trim up won't work. All right, so what you want to do, this isn't specific to Evinrude or Johnson. You can check this out for any other brand of motor. They're all the same, really. So what you've got to understand is you've got your switch at the front on your controls, on your control box, and then that also is in the same circuit as this, which is your rear control for your tilt trim. And then these only run thin wiring and they go up to a relay. And the whole purpose of a relay is allow a wiring, thin wiring on little switches to be switched and then go through to a larger wire, gauge wire, which will go to the motor in this case for the tilt trim. So it goes, those two switches then to the relay, then down to the hydraulic pump. So what we need to do, there's two relays. It doesn't matter what motor you've got, there'll be two relays, and they look like this. There's one for trim up, one for trim down. So what we're going to do, you need to find yours on the Johnson Evinrude. So this is a 95-96 V4, but it doesn't matter, that you'll find them. They're in an easily accessible place and they'll be on the cold side. So all your hot stuff's happening over here. This is the air intake here. So it'll be somewhere around your air intake, your carbies, something like that, or your injection side. Anyway, let's pull these two. They're generic, so you can swap them. So we'll swap them around. All right, let's try that now. So let's try down again. Now we've got nothing for down. Trim up's working, beautiful. Because we swapped them, we know that one of these relays is stuffed on this particular model. Trim down is on the left, trim up's on the right. So this is the trim down relay at the moment, which isn't working. So I'm gonna swap this out. Actually, I'm gonna swap the pair out because these relays, if they were installed at the same time, which they've been both, the tops of them have been cut in a similar manner, so they're probably installed at the exact same time. So I'm going to swap both out, but I'm going to keep that one as a spare because you never know what will happen on the water. So I'll do that now. All right. That's two brand new relays. They're pretty cheap. I actually find there's quite a disparity in the prices of relays. I'd recommend not going to a marine shop. Just go to Repco, super cheap, Napa, whatever you got available, Veals, J-Car. I got these from J-Car, $6. Let's give it a go. We've got up, we've got down. So, as simple as that, just a relay. Yeah. If you come down to the motor and you can go up and down before changing the relays out, of course, then you need to go back to your control blocks box and split it open and check out the switch on the actual control box itself, which I'll do a video for, actually. Just hit like and subscribe. And yeah, I'll split that control box open and show you what the inside looks like. All right, thanks for watching. Please subscribe.